say hi. Hi to all the people. Hi to all the nice people. Yeah, you like all the people. Yeah.
Hello, curious parents. Welcome to University of Connecticut's Hello Lab Presents, a channel all about language and development. If you're a parent with a baby or toddler at home, you probably have a ton of questions about how they best learn to communicate with others.
There we go. Can you try again? There you go, you got the lid off.
Questions like, am I talking to my baby enough? And what should I talk to my baby about are super important. For our first ever episode, let's tackle a related question. How should I talk with my baby? At some point, it's likely that family members, friends, or even doctors have warned you against using so-called baby talk. Baby talk is a scientifically backed language booster for your baby.
Are you shy now? Yeah?
It goes by a lot of names, like motherese or parentese, or even infant-directed speech. We can think of baby talk as a special way of talking to babies that both adults and even kids do without having to think about it. And I bet you already know what this playful, sing-songy form of speech sounds and looks like. Just imagine you're having a baby chat right now. You'd probably raise your pitch.
Good morning, little Woomby princess. Did you have sweet dreams?
Slow things down.
You're learning how to find your voice and have other sounds other than crying. Yeah.
Keep it simple and use short sentences.
What did I find? What are those?
Leaf.
Leaf. That's right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This way of talking to your kid sometimes gets a bad rap because many believe that it will somehow mess up how a kid learns language, especially doing things like imitating baby sounds like goo goo gaga, using cutesy words like wah-wah instead of water, or put on your shoesies instead of put on your shoes. But there's no proof for that. Babies are actually really good at learning different words for the same things. For more on that, check out our next episode on bilingualism.
Saca la lengua. Take out your tongue. Muy bien. Y this is my favorite. Don't let me down, okay? Ready? Un abracito para la mamá. Un hug. Oh my lamp!
It's important to emphasize that there's no scientific evidence that any aspect of baby talk is bad for your little one. In fact, there's tons of evidence that baby talk is actually really beneficial. How so? Baby talk might let your baby know you're talking to them and that they need to really turn on their listening ears. Evidence also shows babies pay more attention to baby talk compared to normal adult-directed speech.
Hey, baby.
Yeah, is that funny?
Is that funny?
While we're still exploring this idea, baby talk might play a key role in making language easier to process for babies. It helps them recognize new words, grow their vocabulary, and learn grammar. And evidence shows this happening with both typically hearing babies and those who are deaf and hard of hearing, such as little ones with cochlear implants. More on childhood hearing considerations in a future episode. And we also know that it exists in some form or another across the world. That's right. Babies all over the globe love baby talk.
Hey, joyeux anniversaire!
Ohio!
Uno.
Uno.
Dos.
Dos.
Tres.
And the benefits of baby talk go well beyond just language learning. Using it makes babies calmer, happier, and it's important for forming social bonds.
Don't do it here, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah. Really? How about the same thing?
This is great stuff, but it's important we point out what baby talk isn't. This special way of talking to your baby doesn't mean that you're speaking unnaturally and ungrammatically. this is not something that's recommended. Of course, as your kid grows, the way you talk to them should too. Baby talk isn't forever. It isn't meant to be. And of course, the bigger a baby's brain, the more language they can handle.
But what's under the hat? How can you let this happen?
Bottom line, whether you call it baby talk or Parentese, your baby learns language by interacting with you. So if this involves a few goo goo gagas, it's more than likely to help boost, not hinder, their language growth. Just remember not to do all the talking. It's important to give your little ones time to respond to what you're saying, too. Until next time.
Right.
Don't just take our word for it. Check out our evidence library on our website to learn about the research that helped us make this episode. Link in description. And there's plenty of awesome languagey topics and baby cuteness where that came from. Check out our next episode, all about multilingualism.